Hi, my name is Hampus Skäring and I'm from CGM. I'm here at our Future Operations Center and today we're about to show you our new software we have developed. It will work with our Extended Operator Workplace and also the KPI software. You will really understand how this software will save time in your organization and how we, with this software, can increase intelligent collaboration in your control room. So you might already be aware of the D3 collaboration desk, but now we have filled it with some content, an application, and together with me today I have Mark Fantisette, who will show us this new application.
Hello. Yes, a P&ID viewer. And why we made a P&ID viewer is because if you look at the process industry, the P&ID is a key document. It enables people to better understand the process and guides them in troubleshooting. So when we wanted to make software for the D3 desk that really improves operator effectiveness, we think that the P&ID is an ideal starting point.
So tell us, how does the P&ID viewer make life easier for operators?
When discussing or troubleshooting using the D3 desk, a lot of different disciplines are involved. For instance, maintenance, operations, engineering, HSE, and similarly, you require information from a lot of different source systems. And you can think about a maintenance management system or a document management system, corporate management system, or real-time data, for instance, from ABB 800XA system. And it's very time-consuming to get your information from all these different sources. And what happens in practice is that people either don't go to all these sources or they make their own collections. They export it or they print it. And the issue is that this kind of private data collections get out of date very quickly. So what we did here with the CGM P&ID viewer is take a P&ID and basically fetch all this information from all these different sources and display it on top of the P&ID. So that makes it an ideal starting point for collaboration and troubleshooting and design exercises.
Okay, so please go ahead and show us.
This is the CGM P&ID viewer, and at the bottom of the screen you can see the main toolbar where you can open documents, look at tags, and there's also a lot of markup tools available. I'll start now with opening a P&ID document. Here, I'll take this fuel gas scrubber P&ID. It opens up on the screen. As you can see, the center part is for viewing the actual document, and at the top we can see an information bar. I will explain a little bit about it later. The D3 desk is a very natural device to view P&IDs because it's very easy to zoom in on complex drawings such as P&IDs to look at the details. And of course you can also rotate these drawings. And again, with the D3 desk, this is very important because, again, the people standing around all sides of the desk, if it's in flat operation, so you can even have people on the other side of the desk looking at the drawings. A very nice feature of the P&ID viewer is that these P&IDs are made interactive, and that means that you can tap on a symbol to get more information about a particular piece of equipment. For instance, I can click on this vessel, the MBF 1080, and a pop-up appears that shows information about this vessel.
So what we are seeing is information from different sources.
Yes, exactly. What we're seeing right now is equipment information from SAP with data points like, is this a safety critical element, yes or no, what's the manufacturer, what's the model number. And in this example, it's just from SAP, but it can in fact come from a variety of sources. Another piece of information that we show about this equipment is the references. That means what related documents do we have. And this can be documents from either SharePoint or a network folder, as you can see here. We are also working together with ABB to integrate things like video feeds, of which you can see an example here, and also real-time data, trends like temperatures and pressures. And this enables central control rooms to also provide support to remote locations.
That is really impressive. Suppose that we have some problem with some equipment. How can the PNI viewer help us with the troubleshooting?
Important information can come from anywhere, the maintenance system or a document management system. Suppose that there is a situation where you want to know, okay, when has a certain piece of equipment been inspected for the last time. If we go up, there's a pressure safety valve here, for instance. And if I tap on this, you can quickly get to certain data points, like when has last maintenance been done, when is the next maintenance due. But important information can also reside in documents, and we can see that there are two related documents here from SharePoint. One is the operating manual chapter that mentions this pressure safety valve, and the other is an inspection report. I can tap on that and quickly go to the actual report. And you can see that this is a fax transmittal, and here at the top we can see the pressure safety valve being mentioned. So these related documents are also found in case of scanned documents or faxes such as these.
So you can simply click on equipment symbol, but does it also work for other kind of shapes?
Yes, certainly. If I move a little bit to the side, you can see different symbols here on the left-hand side. This is called an off-page reference. It's basically a drawing on which the line is continued. I have a flow line here at the top, the GF1033 1-inch A. And if I tap on this preview, I'm taken to the next drawing where this line continues. And in fact, I think it's at the top right here. Yeah, this is it.
Okay, so that really makes it easy. How about the markup tools here?
Yes, of course. Here at the bottom, you see a couple of markup tools, frequently used ones such as a pen tool that you can use to draw on the drawing. We have a marker, which is similar, but it's transparent, so you can highlight things on the drawing. A text tool, an eraser tool to undo your previous markup, a cloud tool, which is also frequently used to indicate a future part of the plant or process, a line, a block, and an ellipse tool.
So how do you save this markup?
You have a section called markup layers, and if I tap on this, screen opens. You can save your markup in a number of layers. This is meant specifically for instance, HACCP sessions, red-blue markup, where you indicate changes to the process, debottlenecking sessions, or commissioning, for instance. You can save your markups per document or across multiple documents into a single markup layer, and can easily add additional layers if necessary.
So is it also possible to view the markup outside the viewer as well?
Definitely. If you look at the top bar, you can see that there's a button called Share, which I can press, and you can share this marked up version of the drawing either to a printer, i.e. print it. You can save it as an image, or you can send it by email.
Thank you, Mark, for taking your time showing us this PNID viewer. So if you would like to have more information about how we can improve operator effectiveness, please give us an email or give us a call and we will help you. Details are provided. Thank you for taking your time.